What you gonna do with all that junk? All that junk inside your trunk?
I'ma get you drunk. Get you love drunk off my hump. My hump, my hump. My hump, my hump, my hump. My hump, my hump, my hump. My lovely little lumps. Check it out.
What's good, everybody? It's your brother Mad Black, the most dangerous and the most toxic black man on the internet. The brother who told you not to vote for that Indian lady, but you did it anyway, and the only thing you get for your vote is to watch her dance. And I'm black up in your face again with some more pro-black commentary. So I'd like to talk a little bit about the Vice President Kamala Harris, and not so much any of her policies, because she really has not introduced any. She has basically has kind of been like an empty uniform in her position as the Vice President of the United States. But when it's convenient for the Democrats, they do like to roll her out there and use her as, you know, like the cheese on the trap in getting black votes. And what I've noticed with Kamala Harris is they like to use her a lot, like, you know, actually having her go out there and dance, or, you know, she'll make appearances at these events that have to do with like hip hop, and they'll put her around black people and have her talk about how much she loves hip hop and rap music, or how she loves black food, soul food and stuff like that. So just lots of buffoonery, really, stuff that really doesn't matter when it comes to being a politician, or what really matters when it comes to being someone who can actually fulfill an actual job and help the people that is your constituency, right? But, you know, I noticed the only time she talks with any type of force or any type of real concern when it is usually for other groups of people. So for LGBT, for immigrants, that's when she speaks up with some sort of force and concern. When it's for black people, you know, she's cutting a jig for you. You know, she's shaking her little bony behind for you, right? And this is version two of what I like to call the Obama hustle, because they really hustled us with Barack Obama when they basically groomed this half African, half white man to be the representative or the avatar for black people in the United States and get everyone behind him, right? They basically got someone who is not from us, not from our actual community, someone who doesn't really relate to us and our community, but we're going to put him in there as like a stand-in and an avatar to pretend like he's part of the black community, and black people will follow him and go along with whatever, you know, we put him out there to do. And, you know, he'll do some of the same dumb stuff. Like, he'll give some rousing speeches like Dr. King. He'll get out there and sing some Al Green, right? He'll smoke some cigarettes, and he'll basically get out there and pretend that he's one of us, and black people will go along with it. Likewise, they're doing the same thing with Kamala Harris. You know, they're putting someone out there who didn't really have a lot of experience with the black community until they got to college. You know what I'm saying? Like, they found someone who was not even black, someone who is Indian, and, you know, might have some other races mixed in there from her mixed heritage from the islands. And they got her out there and had her come out and basically, you know, join a HBCU and join a black sorority and pretend to be a black female. You know, she dated a lot of black guys, so she took a lot of BBC over the years. And that's basically the only really interaction that she's had with black people. I mean, let's just be honest about it, right? And they set her up as another avatar to get out there and pretend to be part of the black community and get black votes for the Democrats and get black people's undying loyalty to the Democrats, because the The Democrats have not done anything for us in a positive fashion. They have not done anything for us in a productive fashion. It's all been lip service. And the best that they feel that they're doing for us is putting these little black avatars, giving these little black avatars a job. You know, they feel like that's the only thing they really have to do for us, or the only thing that we really need is to have these black quote-unquote representatives and avatars as stand-ins in political office, and black people will just be so pleased and so happy to have them. Now, there is at least a bit of an awakening amongst the black community. I do feel like there's an awakening coming through, because for the most part, most black people, I don't even think, really know or like anything about Kamala Harris. The only people you see, the only black people you see celebrating Kamala Harris is always these Democratic liberal plants, these little black liberal bootlicks, right? They're the only ones who praise her. Most normal black people on the street don't talk about Kamala Harris. Most normal black people on the street have nothing to do with her. Even though the ones that claim to be supporters of the Democrats don't say anything about Kamala Harris. They talk about Joe Biden more than they talk about Kamala Harris, right? But the Democrats are still trying to position her to be like the heir apparent and the person that, you know, black people should come out to vote for and support. And I noticed very recently, just over the last month or so, they've been pushing her out there at these different hip-hop events. They've had her out there, videos of her out there dancing. They had one of them where she's dancing by herself, and then they had another one where she's dancing with her white husband. I guess that's supposed to get the bedwench vote, you know, for all the black women that think they have to level up and go outside the community to find a husband, right? So they've been pushing that a lot over the last, like, few weeks or so. And it's just ridiculous to me that that's the only way that the Democrats feel that they can get black people to vote for them, is, you know, put this avatar out there and, you know, show these people out there dancing and having a good time, maybe eating some fried fish or something with some hot sauce on it, and that'll get black people to come in and give you the vote. Once again, I do feel that there is an awakening out there. There are people out there who are not going for the okey-doke, right? And if you really think about it, black people did not support Kamala Harris in her bid to be the president. Remember when she first tried to run? She was running against Joe Biden in the Democratic primaries, and no one wanted to vote for her. In fact, she had the biggest lead at first, and she dropped out very early on because at the very least, like, no black person wanted to support her, and we saw her for the fake that she was. So, I mean, you folks can let me know how you feel about it. If you've been convinced, or you decide to drink the Kamala Kool-Aid and vote this Indian woman, or support her, or act like she is part of you somehow when she's not. Because what they're, I know a lot of the black feminists try to hide behind the whole thing of making it seem like, oh, you're attacking a black woman if you don't support Kamala Harris, or you hate black women if you don't support her. But no, let's stop that nonsense. She's not black, all right? And I know a lot of these divesters and swirlers and better wenches, the only reason they even consider her black is because she's with a white man. Now, if she was with a black man, they would say all of a sudden that she's not black. She's a mixed Indian woman, and she's taking our men from us, right? But because she's with this white man, now all of a sudden she's become a black female that we can emulate and look after and try to be like, right? But once again, for most of her life, she had nothing to do with black people. And even still now, she only comes around us when, you know, certain votes come up or when certain things are getting ready to pop off, like the election's coming up. So, of course, they're going to position her out there as, you know, the gyrating mammy. So you can go out there and support her and think that she's one of you, even though she's not. All right. So let me know if you drunk in the Kamala Kool-Aid. Let me know if you support her. Let me know if you don't. Let me know if you're someone that has seen through her nonsense and decided that you want nothing to do with the Democratic Party during this election cycle. Once again, Before I leave, let me just say, keep it clean. No threats. We're not out here to threaten anybody. We're just saying that we do not support these fake avatar politicians that they get to pretend and be black light and make us vote for them. Okay. Anyway, you folks, let me know how you feel about it in the comments section. Mad Black, and I will be back with my foot on the devil's back.